The city was Jerusalem. The time was long ago. The people called him Jesus. The crime was the he showed, and I'm the one to blame. I caused all the pain. He gave himself the day he wore. And though he taught me how to live, I taught him how to die. And I'm the one to blame. I caused all the pain. Gave himself the day he wore my crown. He could have called his holy son. but he walked right through the gate. And then on up the hill. And as he fell beneath the weight, he cried, "Father, not my will, and I'm the one to blame. I caused all his pain. He gave himself the day he wore my
stay.
when we first begun.
Oh,
shine through the gloom and point me to the skies. Heaven's morning breaks, and earth's vain shadows flee. Through life and death, O Lord,
weep not. Weep not. She is not dead. She is resting in the bosom of Jesus. Heartbroken husband, weep no more. Grief-stricken son, weep no more. She only just gone on. Day before yesterday morning, God was looking down from his great high heaven, looking down on all his children, and his eye fell on Sister Caroline, tossing on her bed of pain, and God's big heart was touched with pity, with everlasting pity, and God sat back on his throne, and he commanded that tall, bright angel standing at his right hand, "Call me death." And that tall, bright angel cried in a voice like a clap of thunder, "Call death! Call death!" And the echo sounded down the streets of heaven till it reached away back to that shadowy place where death waits with his pale white horses. And death heard the summons, and he leaped on his fastest horse, pale as a sheet in the moonlight. Up the golden street, death galloped, and the hooves of his horses struck fire from the goal, but they didn't make no sound. Up death rode to the great white throne and waited for God's command. And God said, "Go down, death, go down, down in Yamacraw and find Sister Caroline. She's borne the burden in the heat of the day. She's labored long in my vineyard, and she's tired, she's weary. Go down, death, and bring her to me." And death didn't say a word, but he loosened the reins on his pale white horse, and he clapped the spurs to his bloodless sides, and out and down he rode through heaven's pearly gates, past suns and moons and stars. On death rode, leaving the lightning flash behind, straight down he came. While we were watching round her bed, she turned her eyes and looked away. She saw what we couldn't see. She saw old death. She saw old death coming like a falling star, but death didn't frighten Sister Caroline. He looked to her like a welcome friend. And she whispered to us, "I'm going on." And she smiled and closed her eyes. And Death took her up like a baby, and she lay in his icy arms, but she didn't feel no chill. And death began to ride again, up beyond the evening star, into the glittering light of glory, onto the great white throne, and there he laid Sister Caroline on the loving breast of Jesus. And Jesus took his own hand and wiped away her tears, and he smoothed the furrows from her face, and the angel sang a little song, and Jesus rocked her in his arms and kept a saying, take your rest, take your rest, weep not, she is not dead, she is asleep. She is resting in the bosom of Jesus.
The song that Tanya sings here was written by her daddy, Rusty Goodman.
When you finally make your entrance to that city of jasper walls and bright as you behold all its beauty and splendor, remember there's just one request I make of you. Look for me, for I will be there too. I realize when you are nigh, there'll be so much to view after you've been there 10,000 years, a million. Maybe to look for me, for I will be there too.
As you go down your list of firsts, there's no question we're gonna wanna see our loved ones awaiting me and you. And when you feel you've shared your story with the last one that wants to hear you tell just how you made it through. Look for me, I'd like to hear it too. I realize when you arrive, there'll be so much to view after you've been there 10,000 years, a million, maybe two, for me, for I will be there too. Look for me, for I the sky shall unfold, preparing his entrance. The stars shall applaud him with thunders of praise. The sweet light in his eyes shall enhance those awaiting, and we shall behold him then face to face. We shall behold. Yes, we shall be. We shall be changed in our
charming roses bloom forever. And we're sad.
Promised for you. To him who in the love of nature holds communion with her visible forms, she speaks a various language. For his gayer hours, she has a voice of gladness and a smile and eloquence of beauty, and she glides into his darker musings with a mild and healing sympathy that steals away their sharpness ere he is awake. When thoughts of the last bitter hour come like a blight over thy spirit, and sad images of the stern agony and shroud and pall and breathless darkness and the narrow house make thee to shudder and grow sick at heart, go forth under the open sky and list to nature's teachings. While from all around earth and her waters and the depths of the air comes a still voice. Yet a few days and thee, the all-beholding sun, shall see no more in all his course, nor yet in the cold ground where thy pale form was laid with many tears, nor in the embrace of ocean shall exist thy image. Earth that nourished thee shall claim thy growth, to be resolved to earth again, and, lost each human trace, surrendering up thine individual being, shalt thou go to mix forever with the elements, to be a brother to the insensible rock and to the sluggish clod, which the rude swain turns with his share and treads upon. The oak shall send his roots abroad and pierce thy mold. Yet not to thine eternal resting place shalt thou retire alone, nor couldst thou wish couch more magnificent. Thou shalt lie down with patriarchs of the infant world, with kings, the powerful of the earth, the wise, the good, fair forms, and hoary seers of ages past, all in one mighty sepulchre. The hills, rock-ribbed and ancient as the sun, the vales, stretching in pensive quietness between, the venerable woods, rivers that move in majesty, and the complaining brooks that make the meadows green, and poured round all old ocean's gray and melancholy waste, are but the solemn decorations, all of the great tomb of man. The golden sun, the planets, all the infinite host of heaven are shining on the sad abodes of death. Through the still lapse of ages, all that tread the globe are but a handful to the tribes that slumber in its bosom. Take the wings of morning, pierce the bark in wilderness, or lose thyself in the continuous woods where rolls the Oregon and hears no sound save his own dashings. Yet the dead are there, and millions in those solitudes, since first the flight of years began, have laid them down in their last sleep. The dead reign there alone. So shalt thou rest, and what if thou withdraw in silence from the living, and no friend take note of thy departure? All that breathe will share thy destiny. The gay will laugh when thou art gone, the solemn brood of care plod on, and each one, as before, will chase his favorite phantom. Yet all these shall leave their mirth and their enjoyments, and shall come and make their bed with thee. As the long train of ages glide away, the sons of men, the youth, in life's green spring, and he who goes in the full strength of years, matron and maid, the speechless babe and the gray-headed man, shall one by one be gathered to thy side by those who in their turn shall follow them. So live, that when thy summons comes to join the innumerable caravan which moves to that mysterious realm where each shall take his chamber in the silent halls of death, thou go not, like the quarry slave at night, scourged to his dungeon, but sustained and soothed by an unfaltering trust. Approach thy grave, like one who wraps the drapery of his couch about him and lies down to pleasant dreams. When Earth's last picture is painted and the tubes are twisted and dried, when the oldest colors have faded and the youngest critic has died, we shall rest, and faith we shall need it. Lie down for an eon or two, till the master of all good workmen shall put us to work anew. And those that were good shall be happy. They shall sit in a golden chair. They shall splash at a 10-league canvas with brushes of comet's hair. They shall find real saints to draw from. Magdalene, Peter, and Paul. They shall work for an age at a sitting and never be tired at all. And only the master shall praise us, and only the master shall blame. And no one will work for the money, and no one will work for the fame. But each for the joy of the working, and each in his separate star shall draw the thing as he sees it, for the God of things as they are.